Hello, you're looking at a 2004 Chevy Cavalier that runs on either CNG or gasoline. Excuse me. Now, this vehicle was owned by the State of Maryland Highway Administration, and it runs on either CNG, which is compressed natural gas, or gasoline. You can see here, it always starts on CNG, and if there isn't any, it switches to gasoline, or you can push this button and it switches to gasoline. I am not sure if there's any CNG in it. I believe that there is, but CNG is not available in this area, but the Highway Administration had the availability of it. So I believe that there is CNG in it, and I believe that it works, but I cannot guarantee that. I've had plenty of them before, and most of the time the CNG works fine. This has the Ecotec 2.2 four-cylinder motor, great motor, bulletproof motor. Here's a motor that has 236,000 miles on it. That's what this has, and everything works. The air blows cold. It sounds great. Now their maintenance is really excellent for the Highway Administration. They're always changing the oil and doing whatever the car needs. It's fixed really with an open pocketbook to keep them on the road. Now it does have some stone chips on the hood and a couple scratches. You can see all of them. Coming by the interior is nice and clean. Really looks hardly used on the inside for 236,000 miles. Got good tires all the way around. Nice clean trunk, which has the CNG tank inside also. Now the CNG tank is certified till December 2017. So that's a pretty long time. Now again, you can either put gasoline in it here, or the CNG in the back. Run it on gasoline forever, run it on CNG forever, whichever you decide to do. I've had people that have bought these CNG cars from me in the past, and some of them have made CNG stations at their home, and have a pump that converts it. And then there are others that have the availability of CNG in the area. And CNG is very reasonable right now. It's only about $2 a gallon. So it's a great way to, reasonable way to run a car. I even had a gentleman that had a pizza delivery business. He told me he has a whole fleet of CNG vehicles because they're way cheaper to keep on the road and way cheaper to run. Just something to think about. Also, I know Utah and there are some other states have a tax credit for those bringing a multi-fuel vehicle or an alternate fuel vehicle to their state. The air conditioning is blowing nice and cold, and it's really blowing cold right now. It's sort of freezing, really. You can see the Maryland Highway Administration maintenance label. This vehicle was used, driven to inspect bridges. So it was constant highway miles. And you can tell it by the way it drives. It's nice and tight, plenty of power. Jumped right up to 60 miles an hour there. No problem. Tight on the road. Now we like CNG cars, but we also look for higher mileage cars that are in real nice shape, that have been well maintained, and government vehicles, and that's what this is. So if you're looking for a CNG car at a reasonable price, or you're looking for an economic economical car to just run on gasoline at a cheap price, that'd be this one too. Or are you just looking for a cheap car? And see, it goes. Got plenty of power. We're getting 32 miles to the gallon. That's what the window sticker said. There's no lights on, no check engine, or all the gauges are good. Now this is a no reserve auction, so please do not bid unless you have your finances together. You'll need $250 at the end of the auction, and the balance is due within 7 days. Now you don't have to pick it up for 30 days. And if you're thinking about shipping, there's a website called uship.com. It's the letter U and S-H-I-P.com. Our zip code is 21014. When you come to pick it up, you'll get a 60-day temporary license tag to drive it home or drive it around home, either one. The title, a clear title, bill of sale, and everything you need to title the vehicle in your state. So buy this CNG or gasoline Cavalier. It runs great, the air is cold, nice tires, and it'll give you a lot of life left to buy this car.